want to look like that.
Just like that. Open the X out. And now footwork goes up against Aaron S. And losing this round 7-6.
The Chris Pincher.
Is this losers finals?
Loser semis.
Losers finals.
Winner here is gonna fight for the IBC double champ.
Oh, okay. Who's the winners?
Vega. I'll show you the epitome.
If Chick, White Beast, and Footwork call laws, who's in winners? Jason?
Round one. Fight!
Is everything okay? Jason.
I said something bad. Yeah, really physical. I don't think I said it enough.
But anyway, Aaron S. in Jackson Horn Footwork still in round one of their first fight. Are they in round one? They're in round one still, right? This is a pretty long round one.
Yeah, this is game one right now.
Looking just really right. Even. Footwork's kind of looking to even up the life lead. Oh, good take. A lot of things. Even when they know it's coming, one of the harder things to like make is like you can't run up bro. So yeah, he was Oh, good trade. He said he didn't care about the trade, I'm gonna just do a lot of special around. So I guess we're hearing about why people aren't playing Mortal Kombat anymore. You can hear it in the background. Yeah, so bad. I didn't think that like this patch would ruin so much of Mortal Kombat though. I mean, I guess they would call themselves releasing, trying to stick to Mortal Kombat 9's laws about like, you know, the somewhat like you can break it type thing. And they tried to normalize it. And I guess that just that was too big of a change for everybody. Like Lanell or Eldrain was saying how he was done because once Cyrex came out he was fine, and then when they packed him, they gave him a cooldown on a special. And I can see how that would like really piss somebody off. Like of all things, that's like the most time sensitive they're fighting, why would you give me a cooldown? That's kind of bullshit. That is bullshit. Oh! Footwork just pulled a Sonic Fox. Oh, never mind. Michigan used to be one of the bigger MKX communities too. The fact that it's like one of them. As much as six people for a turn. Good command. And that's That was a great command grab, don't get me wrong, but I can see it's like that big basically a wrestler on his own. He's like a gay El Fuerte.
He is playing Vega more much better than I've ever seen anyone play him.
I mean, unfortunately, I don't have the luxury of sharing Vegas because the only Vega I know is Matt. Who else plays Vega? I know somebody in Vega plays Vega. Sometimes, even the most have you ever noticed that, like, you see, you have the players that, like, switch to top tiers all the time, right? You know, you got players that bounce around like that, like,
I know, it was happening over there.
Who does that all the time?
No,
not Bonchan.
Q does it?
Yeah, Q, he like, switches up to top tiers all the time. But, like, sometimes he loses to character loyal players, like, you know, people like Mad King that have been playing Vega since Vega came out. Like, he has not changed, even in Street Fighter V, he has not changed his main. Once they found out how Vega worked, he stuck to it, he went right back to it. So, like, I'm just saying, like, people that are character loyal sometimes, like, can out-trump people that are, like, top tier. Yeah, because they already would know the matchup, or they would already know their character's brain data that much from that much muscle memory and training.
It's basically about. Remember that? You ever seen Rambo 3?
What?
You ever seen Rambo 3?
No, I saw John Rambo.
Alright, Rambo 3. What's the general called Rambo something? About a story about a skull who had a piece of rock, who had a big rock.
Right.
The big rock was something special to that sculptor. The next day, he just shows it off, and everyone says, "It looks beautiful. What are you done with it?" He said nothing. The torture was there. I just took away some of the pieces. If you think about that way, your character is there. But the moment in the training room, you're chipping away all the rough patches out.
Right.
And you're getting, you are eventually turning your character into a lean fighting machine. Ready to
execute no matter what game.
Exactly.
Yeah. So, like, shout out, like, and you already know, like, and it sucks, though, because you gotta think about, like, people like Smug and PR Balrog. Like, PR Balrog has always played with Balrog in his name. Like, he's never seen him play with anybody else. I was trying to convert him to colleague, and, like, you see how hard of a time he's having. Like, he's doing great. He is. He's been in, like, top 8s at every major, but, like, still, it's just, it kind of sucks to see them not using their main off-rig.
It's real bad because when I first played Street Fighter 5, I was playing Ken.
Right.
And then I played Adon, and people said, I play a good Adon.
Right.
That's the reason why that's where my name comes from. My real name is Martel, but I mixed Mar and put Adon from Adon and made Mardon. So, because I played Mardon on Street Fighter 4.
Right.
But I had to stop and play Dudley for a while because of Ultra, and then I went to Ryu because I need to learn the fundamentals. And then I quickly grew to Ryu a lot. I feel that I, me and Ryu had some, had sort of a, something in common that we're both, We both learn from it, and we both try to find that something that'll make us strong. Seriously, I mean, Ryu is the most balanced character in the game, and I feel like playing the most balanced character can help, can really help you understand all the other characters.
Shift and White Beast!
All the other characters from behind, whether you play all of them or not.
Right. This just sucks. So, is Footwork out?
Footwork is out for the first time!
Wow. He has been dethroned rather early this week. So apparently somebody just got fucked across the room.
So this is an upset, right here.
That just makes it seem a little bit more amazing how, you know,
35 cents.
You may be here next week. Or you may be, like, the champion this week, but, like, it doesn't guarantee you spot next week. That's kind of cool how, like, Michigan can flip-flop on champions like that. Because I remember, especially, like, in the Tuan days, like, before Tuan was, like, Tuan got super relevant, you just see him just walking on everybody's money.
Are you coming tomorrow, or? What time do you usually get off?
Like, 10?
You can start holding the Mortal Kombat tournaments off a little bit. Or at least just come up and play, because Chad gets lonely after you're playing Mortal Kombat.
Yeah, I'm gonna
go. Jason, trying to keep the Mortal Kombat community alive.
And it looks like everyone's closing up. Xavier, Elgot X is packing up his stream. It's 11:37, almost midnight.
Holy shit, I gotta get home. My wife is so pissed at me.
For all you know, she's probably watching the stream right now. Hey, Jason, is there any way we can look at the chat and see if anyone's been, asking?
Don't scare me like that. He's trying to work his magic. Don't interrupt him working his magic.
I did peek at the chat earlier and did see that Mad King was mad at me for calling him a Street Fighter 4 player.
Oh, why is that a thing? Because
you make it sound like you're ashamed of being a Street Fighter 4 player.
Yeah, like you can't. All honesty, Mad King.
You got a pretty active chat. You got Q, Mad King, the Pews.
Wow. Oh no. Is everybody mad at him?
In there. Seth is in there.
Sound is terrible.
This sounds like a terrible rundown. Like, I'm pretty sure everybody's pissed right now. Like, what the fuck you mean a Street Fighter player? They got beat your ass.
I wouldn't be surprised, because lately when the internet gets degraded, the audio, the vocals for some reason gets degraded.
Vocals?
And it usually happens around this time. Should be okay. We're at on. We'll check it.
Nick Collins. So we have Devil Chips. I just realized Nekali and Devil Chip are like soulmates. Because like both Nekali and Devil Chip have dreads. And like if you look at Devil Chip and then you look at Nekali, they kind of
Nekali versus Bang.
We got
this
Grape Kool-Aid.
Winners finals. Winners finals. Devil Chip versus White Beast.
Yeah. good tag. You see, White Beast is just, he's always been like the crisp kind of player. So like, you rarely see him ever drop the ball. He's always been one about it. You can see it. One thing he does, once he finds a character, he will stick to that character until he is as crisp as it is. Against Devil Chip.
For all we know, Aaron S is waiting to go up against the next person and he's gonna jump in the loser's bracket. He's there patiently looking at his phone. Probably looking at FAT, doing a text or something. One thing for sure, his nerves is not unshaken. He is taking a look at the competition though. And then go back to the phone.
Well, I can tell you what, Mardon, you're too far away from the microphone.
I am.
Yeah.
Yeah, you need to get a little bit closer.
All right, how's this?
Better.
Nick, go up to the microphone. Why do I hear nigga music? Huh? Oh, never mind. I thought it was nigga music out there. What the heck was that? How'd I heard that? Like,
it's
turn
phone.
Off that.
Oh, it's the phone's feedbacking into it. Let me shut that off.
Oh.
Yay. Yeah, you gotta get into the.
Gotta step into it.
Kind of treat you like a sweet nipple. This how you do a stream. Yeah. Kind of twisted a little bit.
So anyway, big question. Another big question for the first.
You know, I tell you what, Mardon is so like well spoken and gentlemanly. I bet you when no one's looking, he just tears that shit up. Like, come here, woman.
He low key sucks the asshole. He doesn't lick it. He's just.
The sour face, Mardon.
It's because you're so literate, man.
Nothing makes up for more like bad man stuff than eating the asshole. That's like that's your get out of jail free card.
No, like real talk though. Eating ass is not that bad. I'm gonna be real with you. I ate my wife's ass out many a time.
Oh yeah, girls are so clean with their assholes. They're not like boys.
Exactly.
I don't even. I think when a girl poops, it doesn't even touch. I think the butthole just opens up and it just falls out.
Right. That shit doopies out in gyms a little fuck when they end up. Like what the hell? Like I don't hear like a tsunami happening.
But like a boy. I mean, we could scrub up to the second knuckle, scrub it out, spray it. But if we're wearing white underwear 3 hours later, there's a skid mark.
Right.
It's like a crayon, like a brown crayon, just comes sticking out, color of the underwear. And anyway,
this is so impossible. But yeah, there ain't nothing wrong with eating that. Is there something wrong with eating that? Do you approve with eating ass?
Doing what?
Eating ass.
Yeah.
See? If footwork does this, obviously clean.
Yeah. I mean, there's not a crisper, cleaner man in the FGC than footwork.
Exactly.
And he's gonna eat a girl's ass.
Exactly.
Mardon, eat that ass.
You gotta eat that ass. You gotta make love to that ass, bro. That nigga, Gray called it a chocolate starfish. That's what you gotta believe that shit is.
Okay, here's
I have one.
I
know what
they're talking about, but two.
I think White Beast has been winning, because he has a lead. Or a streak, I mean. Oh!
Yeah, now he's in a streak. A streak of hits.
The White Beast just comes back at it. He says, you can burn the meter, but you still gotta deal with me in the final round. Oh, you good, dude. See, what I don't get though is how like easy it is to read Nikali's flash.
Incidentally, who is going to Combo Breaker this year?
I know Hollow is. Hollow said he's.
And aside from me, I know I am. I know Darius is. I believe. Yeah, who said Harris?
Where's Combo Breaker?
Hollow's going. Huh?
Where's Combo Breaker?
He's gonna be in Chicago.
Wasn't it in Detroit like last year?
No, Chicago. It replaced UFG TA, UFG, the Ultimate Fighting Tournament. What's the score, guys? White Beast? Alex Lane obviously cheating. Up 2-0. Actually, you know, I've been watching a lot of streams lately. I have not seen a better Fang than Alex Lane.
Exactly. Not even Sonic Fox.
I have not seen nobody play Fang better than
that's
than
why
Alex.
I gave you a shout out earlier today. I said you have the best Fang in the world, man. Smile for me, please. Can you hear me?
He's too focused. He's in a hypnotic trance that it does not allow him to hear anybody.
Right.
Like unless, of course, you're yelling at him.
This is like, he hasn't been able to get past the corn boys.
Really?
The Alex has won every Street Fighter tournament except when Seth and Devil Chip have shown up.
Well, yeah, I've noticed.
This is a good start. So far, he's had a good start. He's already got 2-0. Yeah. I believe this is 2-0. So this is a good start for him.
Maybe it could just be the
this could break the streak right here.
And I think Lance Brandad, I'd have to go back and look, but I don't. I was told that Seth won it.
Yeah.
I don't know. Did he play Alex in Winners or he played Banana Ken? I'm not sure. Seth, you're in the chat. Who'd you beat last round at?
I think it's X-Pac.
Seth beat Alex in Winner.
Okay, I beat Alex in Winner, so.
Okay.
So it won't be a total run back if he wins here, but.
I got faith in him. This is match point.
I believe this is match point.
This is match point. Well, you know, Alex Lane, I honestly, no kidding, I think he's probably would be one of the top players
in Michigan.
Well, in the country if he got a chance to travel more.
And he has such a cool FGC name though.
Oh yeah,
Alex Lane. Like the White Beast, Alex Lane. Like that's so descriptive. That's like the best description.
Well, I mean, you look at how many War Raven Weeklies in a row, you know, cumulative, that Antoine Ortiz won. Alex beat Antoine twice. He took two of those before Antoine left.
Oh really?
Yeah. He's the only person to legitimately beat Antoine Ortiz in finals.
Yeah, the only Michigan player.
Well, Antoine didn't make it to finals the night that Wolf Crone and Perfect Legend showed up. Antoine took third that night. He couldn't get past a Viper.
And anytime Alucard couldn't make it to a stream, remember that time Alucard left and the entire 696 flooded?
Yeah, yeah. Okay, yeah, Seth updating us here. Seth beat Alex in Winners Finals, and then Alex lost to Banana Ken in Losers Finals.
To who?
Banana Ken.
Who's that?
Wow, you are new, aren't you?
Yeah.
Jalen doesn't even know who Banana Ken is. YouTube Banana Ken when you get home.
Yes.
Okay.
He is like one of the best fighting game players in the world, and he's actually from Michigan.
Really?
He was Antoine before Antoine was Antoine.
That's so cool.
And he's one of the nicest guys you'll actually ever meet. In fact, when he showed up to play that last Rambat, like, I thought it looked like, his name's Jose, and I was like, I thought it looked like Jose, but I was like, there's no way Jose would be coming to, you know, to my piddly little Rambat, and I was like, so, what's your name? And he's like, Jose. Also go by Banana Ken. I'm like, my jaw drops. I like felt like such an asshole.
So we got a Birdie versus Vega match.
Oh, this will be fun to watch, actually. I'm actually intrigued by this matchup. Does anybody know this matchup or have seen it?
I think I've seen it one time, but I didn't pay much attention to it, unfortunately.
I'm gonna post the bracket real quick in the stream chat so you guys can follow along.
I'm super curious to see what's Vega's answer for the guy.
skill. I mean, it might just be a new skill, but still, like, I'm super, super curious. Everybody knows you just neutral jump the guy, but like, you know, they can't do anything. Other than his roll.
Yep, Chad. Banana was Twan before Twan was Twan, because Banana Ken was the guy that was pretty much well known as the, like, world famous Michigan. And he'd, I think the first time I played in a tournament was one where he was at, and I remember he played Wolfcrone. It was the first time I'd seen Wolfcrone in person. And those two played an incredible set, and Banana Ken won. And there was a bit of a micro rivalry between those guys for a little bit. Okay, so let's look at the...
How long has Wolfcrone been around?
He's been around pretty long.
How old is he?
He's not that old, but he was around before Street Fighter IV. He just got famous in Street Fighter IV. But, you know, he used to hang out, he used to come to these, and he used to roll with the corn guys.
How old is he, though? Like, is he, like, late 20? Because I know Antoine's, like, going on 30 this year, isn't he?
Yeah, he's got to be late 20s.
Man, I'll be real with you. I honestly thought Wolfram was like 21 when I first saw him. Cause he looked like he could literally be his own South Park character. Like he'll have the exact same design.
Jesus God, people think I'm mean.
When I saw that, I was like, I could totally see you skipping down in terrible graphics down this hallway. Doesn't he though? Like, with the shades and everything, like he's like a little mini Rick Ross.
Well, what was that tournament he just lost to Twan at in Texas?
Texas
Showdown. Showdown.
Yeah, and he had the bandana.
Duh.
And I didn't recognize it as him until the video came up and went to pat him both on the shoulder and accidentally knocked Crone's hat off.
Duh.
I'm blaming the Wolfcrone's loss on that because he just looked flustered. Man, my hat's messed up. My bandana's messed up. I'm fucked. It's all your fault, video.
Ladies and gentlemen, for those who saw that ugly mug of Vegas, we deeply apologize for that.
1-0.
That's funny, bro. Yeah, what's up with the like? How come nobody likes Wolf now, bro? Like, I noticed.
No, I wouldn't say no one. I mean, he's still got a lot of fans. He's still pretty popular.
No, I'm saying like no one from like the Michigan like. Ones that come, like, cause I haven't been here for a while, but I keep up with, like, with the stuff. I know it's like, you even posted something, like, you were talking about Antoine, like, you know, he shows everything possible, does whatever he can. Wolfhound doesn't do this, doesn't
oh,
do that.
Yeah.
Like, when did everybody start, like, hounding on him like that, though? Like, even, like, All Caps was saying, like, once Viper got a nerf, like, he wasn't shit anymore.
pretty much. I mean, he's still got friends, to be like, Him and Q, who's on my team, him and Wolfcrone are really close. So, like, you know, out of respect for Q, I stopped talking a lot of crap about him. But what a lot of people's main problems with him is, like, he was kind of, he's got a reputation of being cheap. Like, you can look up, like, him and Justin Wong agreed to split a pot. And then, like, and Wong agreed to do it because Wolfcrone was looking pretty, sad and broke, and didn't think he was gonna win, and then Wolfcrone won the tournament, and then he wouldn't split with Wolfie. We wouldn't split with Wong.
Bro.
My problem was a combination
when I heard about him stiffing a waitress, and then when he came back from after losing that money match. He was hounding the crap out of me to raise the prices last round at. And then when I wouldn't do it, he posted something about Monday nights about how it's not worth his trouble to come anymore because it's, you know, $2 isn't worth his time. And I'm gonna publicly apologize to Wolfcrone for this. After he posted that, I was in the middle of typing my shitbag response. You know, because, I mean, I blew up at Adonis when Adonis said something bad about $2 drinks, too. And I'm pretty proud of what I got going on here. And
you're doing it massively. You're attracting, like, you're getting a lot of casuals, more casuals than, like, most of them.
And while I was typing that up, I get a private message from Wolfcrow like saying, "Hey Jason, why don't you do a poll to see if there's interest in raising the prices on that?" And what I took it as was him playing the pulling the celebrity card, threatening not to come to Monday nights anymore to try to get me to raise the prices for Rambats.
Right.
Because he just lost that money match to he lost all that money to who? What's his name? The other heel in the FGC. Filipino Champ.
F-Champ.
Lost all the money to F-Champ. So I thought he was trying to... He went to another tournament and did a money match with F-Champ for like...
$500
lost.
Wow. He is like the Meek Mill of the FGC. What the fuck?
So I thought... I mistakenly thought Wolf Crone was trying to pull his celebrity card on me to bully me into raising the prices, and that actually was not the case. Actually, Korn's King Koble told him, "Hey, what, you know, Jason's reasonable. Why don't you ask him to do a poll?" So Wolf Cronin was in good faith asking me to do a poll to see if there's interest in raising the fee from 5 to like 10. And I mistook it as him trying to pull the celebrity card on me. So, you know, I like really blew up on him.
And if he was really struggling like that, he could have like just came up to you like, "Yo, bro, help me out."
Well, too, and it also, in a certain sense, it actually does made as like as many people that agreed with me. That agreed me with you know my opinion on the Wolf Chrome thing, it actually kind of made me look really small because just like 3 weeks earlier I had asked him to join JWE as a member and an owner, and he said he didn't feel comfortable, you know, he didn't want to join the team.
What is JWE?
Jason Wall Raven Entertainment.
Oh, I thought so. Okay.
The premier minister and DJ company in the state.
And you're like sponsoring people?
Well, I got the team, and I do what I can to like, you know, throw some money at people when I can, and I'm looking for actual paid sponsors to make it a real.
So you're like up? You're like trying to be up and coming, like Evil Genius?
Yeah, you know, kind of do a flip side of what Critical Reaction does, and you know, so I'm trying to pull that angle. And at the time, Wolf Crone was pulling a lot of heat over rage quitting. And we got Q, who massively rage quits live. You know, I think twice he's walked up when he's losing his match, and you know, it was like the final, you know, grand finals, and he's lost, and he shut the machine off. Right? He did it once to Antoine, and did another time I think to Alex. You know, so I was like, I had a whole marketing thing built on like, you know, capitalizing on the whole rage quit thing. Like, you know, I had the whole idea for shirts with a picture of Crone holding a Cat 5 cable saying, "No win for you."
Oh, dog.
You know, and the same thing with Q, you know, because he's got that reputation locally. Yeah. I don't know if he does that in line or not, but, you know, Crone was respectful and he turned me down, wasn't shitty about it. And I think emotions, damn, so it's 2-1 right now, right? 2-1 Devil Chip. Losers finals. So, I think it's a situation where Chroma's off his head emotionally, intellectually, after losing all the money, coming back to Michigan. And, I didn't like the attack on Monday night, and I went after him the same way, you know, the same way I went after Adonis. And I can't hear myself at all. Oh, there we go. Mardon hit the volume on the mixer. So again, you know, the opinions of Crone are pretty popular, and I don't apologize for everything that I say. I totally do apologize for coming after him after sending me that private message about doing a poll to raise, you know, see about raising Rambat prices. And, he asked me that in good faith, apparently, and I took it the wrong way. So I do apologize to Wolfcrone, to Josh Philpott.
I hope you do.
Yeah. But then again, that did bring the whole thing up when I was, you know, talking about, you know, that match with him and Antoine at Texas Showdown. when he won that, I messaged Tuan. I was like, fuck yeah, you got your revenge for Yumikon, because Wolfram, after losing to Antoine here at Mid-Masher Mondays, Wolfram lost to Antoine and then disappeared and didn't reappear until Yumikon. And he got a lot of mileage out of doing that with Viper. And so Antoine took that match at Texas Showdown handily. And so I messaged Antoine. I was like, you know, fuck yeah, you got your revenge for Yumikon. And Antoine messaged back, no Viper, no win. And then like 20 minutes later, I see on his Twitter, that's his, he had a hashtag yet, no Viper, no win. And then just brought me back to, even though like maybe he was, Krone wasn't in his right mind, you know, was a little upset when he said it. Oh, and that's going to put Aaron in third, is going to walk away in third place tonight. It's going to be Devil Chip.
And Alex Lang. Or White Beast, SRM White Beast. In the Street Fighter V Grand Finals. It is now midnight.
Hope you don't take this the wrong way, but you got big feet.
Yeah, I do.
I thought you meant me. I got tiny feet.
My daughter was 9 pounds, 12 ounces, 22 and a half inches, and she has the longest, like, talons and claws.
Wow.
Yeah. And I was like, damn. I hope she doesn't have hands like that.
See, I gotta be careful. Like, if I go like to Meyer where they got the second floor, because I got like small feet but a big dick. So if I'm not, if I walk too close to the edge, it'll pull me right through the fucking, you know, right over the edge.
Oh god, that's so stupid, bro.
No, you ever, I mean, I'm just joking. Do you ever see those girls that are like so large chested? You definitely don't want them leaning over the edge.
Yeah,
like,
gravity. Whoa. There's an old gravity adjustment.
Gravity will pull your ass right over.
I'm like, it's small, like it's gonna be quick.
All right, so I think Aaron made back his money tonight.
You take it off,
Mr. The Reverend All Cap, Mr. All Caps.
I'm still salty for that time you put me up against Wolfcrown after I saw it. Like, I didn't even know who that nigga was. Until I saw him, like, mysteriously come out of nowhere at Yomacon. I was like, you gonna put him up to me third round?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Man, I'm trying to get my money's worth. Like, I know I ain't gonna win shit, but at least let me get, like, 4 or 5 confidence boosts, please.
Do you have a dollar?
Thanks, sir. No problem. Yeah, I'll let you know later on in the week if I'm able to come on stream on Sunday.
So here we are, grand finals now. The fight, it's
White Bee's looking strong.
Already put enough. There should be enough poison. Should be enough poison to take down a mule, but Birdie's not a mule.
Yeah, he's dotting him up, though.
This is literally...
While Devil Chip's trying to continue his assault, he's not looking at his health. His health was just going down. It was yelling timber. It was moving.
And this, gentlemen, this is the difference between going home with $17 and going home with $59.
Oh, man.
That's basically what they're playing for right now. Almost over almost $60.
Yo, $59 though. That can like get like a regular man like some ramen, Kool-Aid, and a couple pizzas when he feels like treating himself. Like, that'll keep your ass alive for a week.
What's the reversal?
Well, 39-cent ramen, and you just get like a package of pepperoni to go with it, so you throw some protein in there.
Yeah, like you, man, you know how many niggas that you and them would die for $59 a week, bro. They were fighting coliseums for that shit. Like $59? Shit, I'm down. Mom, Q Cash advance me some money.
Oh, good. Good, in a way, those poisons make good anti-airs in a way.
No, yeah, they are. They're like Alex Lane plays Fang with such crisp and like finesse.
and it is insane. Like, I saw Sonic Fox play Taquito at Texas Showdown. Was it Texas Showdown? I'm not 100% sure. But I was surprised. Look, Sonic Fox is in SF5 now? And I was like, oh, he's got fangs. I was like, oh, okay.
I can honestly see Alex.
And I was like,
cosplaying this too.
Possibly. Alex. If you're like the most well known. Oh, he got the.
Yeah, like I said, he's in a trance.
Right. So, no, like.
We would have had a bigger pot too, but we had like 3-4 people no show. Like, Combros couldn't get out of work.
I know McDougie was stuck at work.
McDougie, yeah, he couldn't get anyone to scoop him up.
Does he have a car?
No.
Okay. He seemed like the type of guy that would have a car. He seemed like the guy to have like an 03 Malibu or something. Or not Monte Carlo. I mean, he seemed like the type of person that would drive a Monte Carlo. Oh, good grab. Good
Devil
grab.
Chips saw that coming.
Devil Chips not looking to end his path to victory just yet. Oh, he dived in. Oh, he is doing the worst. What I'm loving right now is like the super fundamental jab short special. Like, that is just so. I feel like I'm in Street Fighter 2 again. What's going on? Talk to me.
Oh, Lord. Oh, man.
Oh, sorry, folks. Yeah, the names are wrong. Sorry, I was doing payouts.
Patient game now.
Oh, the V trigger. The V reversal. The V. Nothing. The dots.
Oh, no.
The grabs.
Those rings.
The blocks are phenomenal. The meaties.
Ken didn't even touch him.
Is that 1-0 right now?
That is 1-1.
1-1. We are getting. It you know, is going to be an interesting match, ladies and gentlemen. I kid you not.
You know, the first time I saw Birdie, I thought he had keloids in his ears. Oh, why the hell are your ears so small? What the hell, Spectre?
Oh, that was.
Take care, Brad.
I'll see you later, man.
Right. Be safe, man.
Keeping all that poison on him as much as possible, so that it'll hopefully drain as much of his life as possible. Oh, but
yeah,
it doesn't work.
Chad Brady, Brad.
He gets out of it. Ooh, escape from the grapples of Birdie. And into the grapples of Fang.
Good dodge.
Alright. Now, oh, good slide from Fight Beast. The shorts
will save your life in any situation. When in any doubt, do a jab or short, and you will win the round. I promise you. It is such a cheap tactic, but it's so fun. It's so cool.
Oh!
Oh, good grab by Devil Chip.
Oh!
I just realized, do you think Michigan is kind of like the birdie, like, central area? Like, we have so many birdies here.
So many suburbs?
Birdies.
I have.
Birdie players.
I think so. In this case, do we have too many birdies sometimes.
I'm just thinking, like, we got Hollow, Q, Chip, Mad King has a birdie. Twan has a birdie. He tapped into his Michigan roots. He said, I need an alt. But like, Michigan is like, I think, got the most birdies. Oh. They're burning the time. Alex Lane does not care. He will wait you out. Sorry.
It looks like White Beast is trying to go for a long range game. Not until he has the opening for a short range, and it seems to be working for him. Oh!
He will chase you down.
He doesn't need to do anything at this
point.
He doesn't need to do anything because he needs
just
to.
Just got a good.
He beat him. It was going to be a timeout.
Just like Fang.
He really didn't need to do anything at this point. He took down enough light.
He just had to guess the right hit.
So we're all tied up in this match. Birdie takes the poison.
Oh, good trade. Traded up the cannon. Trying to make it.
Oh, look at this! Look at this!
Look at Bird! And he
took a lot of life from Birdie.
Maybe if Birdie had 100 less life, he would have been good. He said.
And game two goes to White Beast.
Alex Lane, the White Beast. Has anybody? Is there any reason why like Fang is still an acronym? Has anybody figured that out yet?
We're still trying to figure that out.
All right, so White Beast one game away from a.
What if Fang stands for fucks all?
We need his first
rand
bat.
Or finger all niggas grannies. That's what Fang starts.
Finger all niggas grannies.
That's what Fang starts for. He's weird enough to do that shit. Like, yo, bro, what's up? I'm gonna finger your grandma.
Dude, don't work that one.
Don't work.
Bro, what if Fang starts with fingers all niggas grannies? Like, yo, dog, what's up? I'm gonna finger your grandma.
Oh, sorry, folks. I had it on the wrong screen.
Oh, God.
My apologies. We joined this match in progress.
That was so funny, man.
God damn it. I did that at least once a broadcast. I'd been
good. Oh, that was nice.
I'd done good. I hadn't done it for several weeks.
Now
and then
Lane,
one joke about fingering black people, black grannies. And I leave it on the wrong screen.
Finger all niggas grannies. Like, that's exactly the thing it stands for, though. Like, he's the exact person to be like, what's up, nigga? I'm a finger your grandma. Like,
that's all that was. That's all that was.
Oh, he takes the hit? Chip,
now he's on
turning
Tori. Alex is on tournament point. And he escapes.
Oh, he's even wearing a Seraphim shirt tonight.
All this poison, and Birdie still got a lot of life.
I just noticed that Alex Lane is sporting his SRM t-shirt.
Yeah. I don't know who's going to be the white. Don't they normally wear it, like, mainly on the main event?
Well, that changed real quick. Oh, missed a good combo.
Oh, there it is.
But
he tried to die.
Birdie. Nice.
There we go.
In.
What
this
can he do? What's he going to do? What is he? He's waiting him out. Oh.
I don't think there's anything he can do.
Oh, this is what matters. This is make or break for Devil Chip. If he can guess the right combo. We can guess the right counter.
He's rushing it. He's rushed there.
Then Alex Lane takes the Michigan Rambats for the month of May.
White Beast takes its first Rambat.
The Midwest Monthly number 5 Michigan Rambats, your Street Fighter V champion, Alex the White Beast Lane.
Fuck you.
You know,
so it's 12:14 now,
and we're actually done.
Oh, I gotta go home.
Too bad Monday nights can't be like this. All right, this is Jason Warraven, Mardon, and Jalen, Rad Dad.
Yeah, Rad Dad Jalen.
Peace out, and we'll see you tomorrow night.
Take care, America.
Warraven Weekly 112. And like I said, you know, the room's not dead. It's just everyone wants to be on this side of the room.
Exactly. Mic drop. I'm gonna be done in that.